Hello friends, welcome to the class. In this video lecture we will discuss about introduction of graphical method. Graphical method is used to find the optimal solution of LPP when there are only two decision variables. So it is very popular for two decision variables. As the decision variable increases, its difficulty to visualize is also increases. So we preferably use this for only two decision variable. Let's start the lecture. Graphical method, also sometimes known as geometrical method, is pictorial representation of solution process. So in this method, you can actually visualize what is your feasible region, what are the corner points, which constraint is binding constraint, which constraint is redundant constraint. So all this information you can get by viewing the solution. So easy to handle with two decision variables. So graphical method generally used with only two decision variables. You can use for three decision variable also, but in that case the solution process becomes tedious and laborious and very difficult to visualize. So generally used with two decision variable only. Let's talk about some basic definition. So Solution is nothing but any specification of value of decision variable is called solution. So it might be positive, it might be negative, it might be zero. If we talk about feasible solution, then the solution that satisfy all the given constraint, then the solution is known as feasible solution. Infeasible solution, a solution that violate at least one of the constraint, then the solution is known as infeasible solution. There are so many feasible solution. So our task is to find out optimal feasible solution among these all the feasible solution. So a set of feasible solution are known as feasible region. So in feasible region, there are so many feasible solution possible. So out of this all the feasible solution, our task is to find out optimal feasible solution. Redundant constraint. So if constraint when plotted does not form part of the boundary marking the feasible region of the problem, then it is said to be redundant. Inclusion or exclusion of redundant constraint does not affect the optimal solution of the problem. So this is nothing but if you add redundant constraint or remove the redundant constraint, it does not affect on the optimal solution of the problem. Binding and non-binding constraint. So once the optimal solution of LPP has been obtained, then if right hand side and left hand side of the constraint are equal, when substitute the value of optimal decision variable into the constraint, then the given constraint is a binding constraint. If left hand side and right hand side are not equal, then constraint is non-binding constraint. So your solution process will be like the picture which is given in the background. So let's say, so it contains one axis, this is my x1, this is my x2, these two are the constraint, these two are the constraint. Let's say this is my first constraint and this is my second constraint. Less than or equal to type constraint always moves towards the origin. And if your constraint is greater than or equal to type, then it will always moves away from the origin. So these are the corner points P, Q and R. Yellow shaded region is nothing but your feasible region, which is bounded by these two constraints. Let's take an example. Let's say there are three constraints, 1, 2 and 3. Okay, so if you closely observe this figure, then constraint 2, which is denoted by this black line, constraint 2 already satisfy the constraint 3. So if you remove this constraint 3, it does not affect the optimal solution. Okay, so constraint 3 here is nothing but redundant constraint, and this is your feasible region. bounded by constraint 1 and 2. Now, if we talk about binding constraint, so let's say if your optimal point is the intersection point of these two, right? So obviously, then if you put the value of optimal decision variable into constraint 1 and 2, then it will satisfy. So that is nothing. It is nothing but if your constraint is passing from the optimal point, then the constraint is binding constraint. Okay. If the optimal solution is this point, okay. So in that case, constraint 2 only binding constraint. Constraint 1 is not binding constraint. So I hope this is clear now. Now coming to the methodology to follow to find out the optimal solution using graphical method. So first task is formulation of problem. So whatever the problem is given in the descriptive data, convert it into a mathematical form. Then draw x1 and x2 axis and plot all the constraints on the graph. Convert inequalities into equalities and plot on the x1 and x2 axis. So let's take an example. Let's say this is my constraint 2x1 plus 3x2 less than or equal to 6. I have to plot on this graph. So this is my x1, this is my x2. So first task is to convert inequality into equality. So here inequality is less than or equal to type, right? So convert into equality. Let's say this is my 2x1 plus 3x2 equal to 6. Now to plot this constraint on this graph, put x2 equal to 0 and find the value of x1. So you will get x1 equal to 3, right? You will get this point. Similar way, put the value of x1 equal to 0 and find out the value of x2. You will get x2 equal to 2. So this is the point. Connect these two lines. So this line is nothing but 2x1 plus 3x2 equal to 6. Now our objective is to plot this equation less than or equal to type constraint, right? So less than or equal to type inequalities. So to plot less than or equal to type inequalities, always moves towards origin. Okay. So from this point moves towards origin. So this whole region satisfied this inequality less than or equal to type constraint. Draw the line over here like this. If you get confused over here in which side I should move, so in that case select any point over here. Let's say this is my point. So coordinate of this point is 2, 0. Put this coordinate into this. So 2 into 2 plus 3 into 0, that is 4. So 4 is less than or equal to 6. So this point will lie in the feasible region. So from this line you should move towards this point. So this whole region indicates less than or equal to type constraint. Okay. So this way you can identify on which direction you should move. So this is nothing but feasible region. Similar way, let's check if I have greater than or equal to type constraint. So first task is to convert inequality into equality. Convert inequality into equality. Draw that line over here. So this is the same line. Now in which direction should I move in that case? Let's select again any point over here. Let's say this point. So this point this point has a coordinate 2, 0. Now put the 2, 0 over here. So 2 into 2, 4 plus 3 into 0, 0. So 4 is not greater than or equal to 6. So this point will not lie in the feasible region. Okay. So you should not move in this direction. Now let's take about this point. So this point is nothing but 0, 3. Okay. So 2 into 0 plus 3 into 3. That is 9. 9 is greater than or equal to 6. So you should move away from the origin in this direction, right? So this is your feasible region. So I hope this is clear how to plot constraint on the graph. Any constraint you can plot easily by selecting a random point and check whether that point is lie in the feasible region or not. Next task is to identify the feasible region. Once you plot all the constraints, you will get the idea about the feasible region. So region that satisfy all the constraints is your feasible region. At this point, you have two methods to find out the solution. One is corner point approach, also known as extrema point enumeration. Second is isoprofit function line approach. So let's talk about our first method, corner point approach. So in this method, find the coordinate of all the corner point of feasible region and find the value of objective function at each corner point. The point at which objective function is maximum in case of maximization problem or minimum in case of minimization problem is the optimal point, and coordinate of that point gives you optimal solution. So simplest method to find the optimal solution using graphical method, corner point approach. Second is isoprofit function line. So iso means equal. On isoprofit line, profit or cost remain equals. To draw isoprofit line, put objective function z equal to 0. So first isoprofit line will pass from the origin. As isoprofit line moves away from the origin, its profit contribution increases or cost contribution reduces. So methodology which you should follow to solve the problem using isoprofit line is: draw a x1 and x2 axis. First task is to draw x1 and x2 axis. Then take a suitable scale and plot all the constraints on the graph and find out the feasible region. At this point, only find out feasible region. No need to find out the corner point coordinates. Draw isoprofit function line by making z equal to 0. If your objective function is maximum z equal to 5x1 plus 3x2, then your isoprofit line becomes 5x1 plus 3x2 equal to 0. With the help of roller scale, draw a parallel line to the isoprofit line which is passing from the farthest corner point of feasible region in case of maximization problem and nearest corner point in case of minimization problem. Find out that coordinate of that point only. That is your optimal solution. So in this way you can find out. So in isoprofit function line approach, no need to find out the coordinate of all the corner point. Only corner point which is farthest away from the origin if your problem is maximization, and nearest to the origin in case of minimization problem. So only need to find out one corner point only, and that corner point will give you an optimal solution. Yeah, so that's it. So that's from my side. Thank you very much. If you have any doubt, you can put it into comment box. I will be very happy to help you. Thank you again.